everyone. If you have not met me yet, I'm Mr. Dial. I'm the choir director here at Santa Clara High School with our lovely Superior Rated Choir program. And I am so happy to see such a full audience for our first concert of the year. Just some preliminary things to talk about. If you would all please silence your cell phones. Do not disturb. I know some of you want to take video, take pictures. So I'm not necessarily going to tell you to turn off your phone. But if you can at least put on Do Not Disturb and silence it for me, that would be great. Airplane even better. And then that way we don't have ringers going off. I don't love to hear that when you're trying to sing a real touching song and then all of a sudden you hear the Apple, the standard Apple ringtone going on. So if you need to get up for any reason, there are bathrooms in the lobby. If you need to step out for whatever reason, I do ask that you try to make it at a time that there's not people singing on stage. So if there is between songs, if you need to step out, you may do so. One of the exit doors there, they do kind of slam, so you can try to be real gentle about it. That'd be great. If you have any children in the audience and they're being a little rowdy, I ask that you do remove them to calm them down, and then you can bring them back in to enjoy the rest of the concert. There will be three different choirs that you're going to hear, and afterwards there will be a slight intermission, probably about 10-minute long intermission, to set up for our closing with High Profile and Entourage singing their songs on stage. So there will be a slight intermission where we can have lights go up and everything. You guys can do your thing, stand up, stretch, and then we'll call you guys back into the seats once we are ready to finish up the show for you guys. So I hope you're really excited. We have our first group of the night starting with Una Voce. So if you guys can stand.
much louder. As the women from Chamber are joining us, we are singing a song that's called Truth. It's actually a song that I've always wanted to do with a women's choir. I see it a lot in the honor choirs across the state, but it's a beautiful song. It's really clear to see how cool it is that they're singing this. But the message behind it is even cooler to me, because you guys know your own children, you know your friends, and you know how special they are, you know how wonderfully talented they all are, but sometimes they don't see that. And when talking with them, we talked about the commonalities that they might have with each other, that are assumptions that people make about them that aren't necessarily true. And that's what this song is about. It talks about how we are all born from the earth, and we aren't born with all these insecurities and all of these negative thoughts about ourselves. Those are born out of other people saying those things about us. And we talked about how many of them suffer from anxiety, how many suffer from depression, how many have had bad things said about them. And we saw a lot of commonalities with them. And it just really made this song even more special, because the whole point of this song is that none of those things are true just because someone else said it. What's true is how you feel about yourself. So I hope you get that message from this. So we have Truth, and we have our drummer, Caden. I thought he was there. Caden. Little did you know, we're doing a chorus show and a comedy show. So I hope you enjoy. Thank you. All right, up next is our chamber choir. This is our mixed group of men and women. They are only singing two songs for you tonight. One that is accompanied by our student accompanist, Dave Guevara. The other is by Miss Hibbert. Our first song will be Hold Fast Your Dreams. This is another song that I unapologetically stole from the honor choirs over the years and have wanted to do. We will be taking this to our MPA in the spring, in March. And then our second song is a song called I Love You, which is a beautiful arrangement about essentially heartbreak, a love that is no longer there, but it once was. So I hope you enjoy our Spirit Reader Chamber.
This living fire started in my heart, reaching a fever pitch, is bringing me out the dark.
Why don't you?